proportion from it, ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talk anything, the Prophet gave the answer to you. How to wear the footwear, how to wear the shirt, how to wear the trouser, what to do when it's old, how to behave when it's new. Everything, man. Who is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He is not anti-Christ. He is not anti-human beings. He is not anti any good thing. He is our savior. Lamartine, a French writer who wrote the book Histoire de la Turquie. In his book Histoire de la Turquie, in French he wrote it, which means History of the Turks. Volume 2, page number 276 and 77, he says, if greatness of purpose, smallness of means and astounding results are the three criteria to judge any human genius, I would well ask, is there anyone greater than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He is saying, get me the best in the world and show me, if you can, on these three criteria. What are the things? Greatness of purpose. The Prophet says, I have come to change the entire universe forever. The purpose is so great. Smallness of means. How small are the means? So we come to know, at the time of his death, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 3, hadith number 2513, he wanted some ration. He didn't have money. He took his armor to a Jew. He kept it with the Jew. Took the ration from the Jew. What is the means? At the time of death, he doesn't have food to eat. Riyadu Salihin, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she says, the last 3 days of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was staying with me in my house. For these 3 days in my house, we did not have oil to lit the candle. We did not have food except a dry date, which I would dip in the water and I would suck it from one side and he would suck it from the other side. This is the smallest of means. But what are his intentions? Change the world. If greatness of purpose, smallness of means, what are the results? Astounding results. Who says they were astounding? Encyclopedia Britannica says. Encyclopedia Britannica, it says, the greatest revolution on the face of the earth is the Islamic revolution brought by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Greatness of purpose, smallness of means, astounding results. You want to imagine how astounding the results are? The non-Muslims, they worship Jesus as the God, the Son of God. There are Hindus who worship about 330 million idols, 33 devis and devtas they worship. But they don't take their God so seriously, as much seriously with love and affection we take only the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astounding results. We are ready to die for him. Not blindly. We believe in him that he was a perfect personality on earth. Show us a fault, man. We challenge you for a public debate. You can't. Astounding results. Three criteria to judge any human genius. I may well ask, who is saying this? Not a Muslim. Lamartine, a non-Muslim, he says, I may well ask, I want to ask somebody, is there anyone greater than him? No, nobody is greater than him. Michael H. Hart, he is still alive, an American. He writes a book in the year 1972, published from the New York, by the name The 100, a ranking of the most influential persons in history. He's a Christian by faith. He says, who was the best of all the human beings till the from the time of Adam alayhi salam? He counts. Gandhiji, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Socrates. He counts the names of the top people. Einstein, Newton, everybody he counts. Being a Christian, he puts Jesus on the third position. He says he's the third great person. Second, Newton. First, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says reason. On page number 33 of this book, he says, my choice of Muhammad to lead the list of the most influential men in history may surprise a few readers and may be asked by others as a question to me. May surprise a few readers and may be questioned by others. But I say, there was no man in history as successful as Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on both secular and religious level. Why do you hate Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What wrong did he do? You say he practiced jihad. I say, man, statistics are wrong. You don't know about his jihad. The Prophet in his life, went out with the Muslim army 27 times. Out of the 27 times in his life that he went out, fighting took place only in 9. And in 9 times that he fought, only about maximum, I am saying, 250 non-Muslims were killed. How many? Only 250. How many by his sword? By the sword of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Only one. And still you call him a terrorist? Still you call him a terrorist? If he would have used the sword, the best time was when he was capturing Makkah for his personal revenge. They forced him out of Makkah. He is re-entering Makkah with a force. The people in Makkah, they are afraid that he will take a revenge. The Sahaba with Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while entering Makkah, entering the boundaries of Makkah, they are giving a slogan, Al-Yawma Yawmul Malhama. Today is the day to throw the flesh of the enemies into the air. Al-Yawma Yawmul Malhama. The Prophet is riding in front of them on his horse. He turns back. He says, wait, what did you say? Al-Yawma Yawmul Malhama. Today is the day to throw the flesh in the air? La. No. Al-Yawma Yawmul Marhama. Today is the day of having love and mercy to them. I'm saying, still you'd say that he is a terrorist. You say he spread Islam with sword. D. Lacy O'Leary, in his book Islam at the Crossroad, on page number 8, he says, history makes it clear, however, that the legend of the fanatical Muslims spreading Islam at the point of the sword upon the conquered races is the most fantastically said absurd myth. He said, if there is anything that is more absurd, more stupid ever said, that stupid thing ever said is that Islam was spread by a sword. Thomas Carlyle, in his book Hero and Hero Worship, he says, the sword, oh, you are saying by sword he spread it, the sword indeed, but where will you find that sword? Oh, where is that miraculous sword? We should get that sword today. With one sword he did this miraculous thing. How many people ready to die for him? 1.3 billion people. Ready to die for him. We didn't see him. We didn't hear his voice. We never met him. We are ready to die for him 100 times if we get an opportunity. And we are proud to die for him. And what is Thomas Carlyle saying? He spread it by sword. A sword indeed. But where will you find that sword? Every new idea at its starting is in a minority of one. It's in the mind of one man, yet it dwells there. It is one man against all the men in the world. For him to take a sword and to propagate it will do little. I say, first bring that sword to me. Where is that sword? Get it. With all atomic bombs in your hand, you are unable to convince the people that you are our boss. With all atomic bombs, you are unable to convince that you are our boss, and you expect that the sword of Muhammad converted so many people as Muslims. Shame on you for the lies you speak. You liars, you cheaters, you deceivers, and you still you call yourself civilized society of the West. You cheaters, correct yourself. You shameless creatures on earth. Be honest. You talk of honesty. Which honesty are you talking of? You corrupt fellows. You are looting your poor people. Through Muhammad's command, through the Quran he gave,